today's session, we're going to be looking at musicality. Musicality is one of your greatest tools when you're presenting a group exercise to music class, not just for your assessment and your exam, but actually can be the essence of what keeps your attention high when you're working with your clients, either group exercise to music, indoor cycling, circuit. You can use musicality in circuit training, although it's not part of the assessment criteria, and also aqua to music, or group exercising in the water. So with your musicality, what's essential is that you have an understanding not only of the beats and the speed of the music, but also how the music makes you feel. And you also need to look at the demographic of your class in order to work out what kind of music that they enjoy. So if you've got a bunch of 18 to 20 year olds, you're not necessarily going to be using back to the 60s music. And conversely, if you've got older people in your class, you're not going to use the latest sort of banging house tunes. So what is important is that you need to be able to recognise the rhythm of the music, the feel of the music, and also how music is structured. Music is like the spoken word, really, but with music. So when we look at our beat, the one, is like just a single word in a sentence. The sentence is the phrase, and that always, in music, contains 8 beats. Okay? And then our phrases, our 8-beat phrases, 4 of those are called a block. So that equals 32 beats. 32 beats, when you're working pure exercise to music, is how you're going to structure your choreography to make it effective, to make it logical, and to help everyone work in time with the music. When you're working with group indoor cycling or with aqua, then you may be working what we call track to track. So you'll be working chorus verse of a structured piece of music. You'll make choices that aren't all necessarily merged together and professionally mixed. So what's going to be important is when we're also going to look at in the practical session that goes with this lecture, is music mapping, as well as getting an understanding of you with your beat, your phrase, and your block understanding. So these are really important terminologies: the beat, the phrase, and the block. Remember, the phrase is like the sentence. The phrase is the part where you have to be able to recognize the beginning of a phrase in order to go at the right time. There is nothing more frustrating for a client if they've got good musicality and their instructor doesn't have that. So it's important that your participants are never leading you, that you're in charge, you've got leadership of your session. Understanding your music is essential. It's essential. It's like going out on a journey in a car, somewhere you've never been before, and not taking a map with you. If you don't know what's coming and what the way is, A, you might get very lost, and B, you might miss some really good opportunities on your way. And those opportunities in a group exercise to music class are the performance opportunities, the things where we can make the most of the things that happen in the music. And they're important that you, as you develop as an instructor, not just for your exam class, but when you develop as an instructor, that you out there and you give it some performance to have some fun with your clients. Because it's not all about just hard slog. It should be about helping them to enjoy themselves, to have a bit of de-stress time, and to make the most of the music. What does that music make you feel like doing? See, all these things you have to consider as you go through working with beat, phrase, and also the block. So move this one across now. When we look at the structure particularly if we're working with the track to track, as I mentioned, in group indoor cycling or in aqua. When we're working track to track, it also can be group exercises to music. If you're bringing them into, you might build them through the curve, and then you might have a performance track right at the top of the curve to bring everything together. You might not. But when you look at a piece of music, then there will be an introduction. So there's a part of the music that brings you into the track. It's usually instrumental, okay? And it's usually fairly low level, low feel, lower energy than the rest of the track is going to be. There's also the verse. Now the verse in most music is like the story. It tells you the story about what's happened. Okay, so this is usually where you're doing your work and the intensity is maybe slightly lower, bringing you to the chorus. The chorus is kind of like the thing that's repeated. It usually has repetitive vocal lines in there. And the chorus is where you can really play and have a great time, or you can work a little bit harder, okay? And then combined with those three aspects, you have the bridge or the instrumental piece. Now, the bridges and the instrumentals are sometimes where you can have the little play, the little performance parts as well. Not every track will have a bridge or an instrumental, yeah, or something different. It can also be used, if you're doing group exercise in music and cycling, you can also use it with to bring them back and rest them, a quick water break. It doesn't always have to be the uber high energy. You also, at the end of this, might have what we call an outro. I forgot that. Outro. So that's kind of like the reverse of your introduction. With the verse and the chorus, they might be repeated 3 to 4 times during the track. Generally, as the energy builds in the track and the emotion builds in the track, then the choruses, they may double chorus, or they may make the chorus much more energetic than the first time you heard it. So all these things, when we're looking at music mapping, like going on our journey for the first time, then these things are going to be the things that you, as a group exercise instructor in whatever discipline that you're going to be looking at, because it's important that you know what's coming on your journey. You're the fitness leader, and you have to lead the journey forward and know where you're going with it. If you get lost, the group have not got a chance of getting and feeling successful. Okay, so it's very important that you take them on that journey in a very controlled way. Okay. The other thing you need to be looking at when we look at music is it's on your resources. You do have a musicality PowerPoint that goes alongside this lecture and the practical that we're going to be doing in a moment. What is important is that you know your approximate speeds or beats per minute as we go through your music tracks. So on your PowerPoint, you'll see we recommend for your warm-up that you're working between 120 and 128 beats per minute for your warm-up, okay? Now, all the beats per minute that we're giving you for your recommendations, for your, this is for your group exercise to music, your aerobics, your basic ETM, these beats per minute are particularly important that you keep it, that during your assessment class, that you're able to use all the skills that we see on the grid. We know that when you're out there in industry, you're probably going to be working a little bit quicker, maybe not, depends on your target group and their needs. But what's important is that you give yourself a chance during your assessment class to show us your teaching skills, observation, teaching points, correction, and actually being able to physically execute the exercise effectively and enable your group to do so. So don't think faster is better for the sake of your assessment. Once you've got all your skills and you're really proficient Yes, of course, you can go on and you can teach to faster beats, particularly in the aerobic curve. Okay, so your warm-up is, we recommend 120 to 128 beats per minute. Your mixed high-low aerobics on your conditioning curve, we recommend from about 126 to about 145. Just looking at my notes to make sure I don't say the wrong thing. And then your muscular strength and endurance goes from about 110 to maximum 128 beats per minute. But bear in mind with your muscular strength and endurance, you don't have to do everything single time. You can do it slower rhythm on the half beat, or even doing it four counts to one beat. So you don't have to do really, really fast movements. Okay? Your post-workout stretches, my suggestion for your music choice there is something always very, very nice and easy, something easy on the ear, probably moving away from any of the big love ballads, because that tends to make some people emotional, and you don't want to kind of spark up any emotions that you then can't deal with within your group. When we look at music choices, what you need to be thinking about is, how does it make you feel? If the music is a little bit flat, then when you're working that in a group, odds on, if you've got quite a good ear for music, it's not the right music to use. Or use it in a different part of the class, maybe use it for the post-workout stretch. You've got to feel the emotion as it builds through the track. You've got to be able to use that, and you've got, not so much for your assessment class, but when you're out there teaching, to give you the edge when you're actually out there working in industry. You don't want to be some mediocre group exercise instructor, you want to be really exceptional. And the music is a tool that's going to really help you to get to your clients, to keep them coming back, let them enjoy and have a great time during your class, as well as burning those calories and achieving their goals. But you've got to feel and play the emotion of the music. So if there's a really big kind of emotional, kind of really exciting, energized part of the music, don't start just talking across it and think about what's coming. Give all your instructions, feel the music, and then when that part finishes, when that crescendo finishes, then you put in some more instructions, or you praise people. But don't talk about a part across the best parts of the music. It's got to be motivating, and you've got to think about how you work with that music and your performance of that music. Okay, it's really important that you're able to let yourself go a bit in class and help people to relax, because if people, and particularly in group exercise to music classes or step, if they're coming in and they get it wrong, they feel a little bit foolish. So if you're larger than life and you can kind of create an atmosphere that's quite relaxed, they won't quite feel so glad about that. So use your performance, have a little sing, move around, try and be as relaxed as possible with your clients in your class. As well as using the highs of the music, there are also times when you use the lows of the music, particularly the bridges and instrumentals. They might be the highs of performance, but they also might be the times when you can bring it back. They can't constantly keep pushing out high energy. You need to give them recovery points. Yeah? Not recovery so that they go down to like a 5 or below, like they were in their warm-up RPE scale. Then we're still looking at maintaining intensity, but they can't just keep pushing out high energy. You have to give them some moments to come back a bit. Of course you're going to be offering alternatives and progressions all the way through, but you also need to naturally bring back, when the music comes back, you also need to come back with it. It's vital that you can work out your beats per minute for each section of the class. And when you're writing your plan for your exercise to music or any of your level 2 group exercise disciplines, you need to outline the name of your track and the beats per minute that you're using for that. So that's important as part of your planning, that you know what you're doing. What we also like for your exercise to music specific class is for you to music map 1 track so that we see you know how to break down the track. We also like to see that in the group indoor cycling and planning as well for just one track. Okay, what we're going to do now, we're going to go on to our next video, which is going to be the practical of working with our beats per minute and music mapping.